coming up next on INC Radio. Sunday, 9 o'clock p.m., Macau Satellite Studio. 10 o'clock p.m., Spain Satellite Studio. 11 o'clock p.m., Western Europe Satellite Studio. Stay tuned for more exciting programs only here on INC Radio.
Bienvenidos. 欢迎来到. Hoida. Welcome to INC Radio. Anim sa pitong kontinente. Mahigit sa 100 bansa at teritoryo, iba't ibang kultura at lengguwahe, nagkakaisa at nananatiling solido. Ito ang INC Radio.
Radio DZEM 954, ang tinig ng katotohanan, himpilan ng Iglesia ni Cristo, sumasahimpapawid mula sa Quezon City.
Ang himpilang ito ay kasapi sa KBP, kapisanan ng mga broadcaster ng Pilipinas, ang ating Philippine Standard Time, alas 9:01 na ng gabi dito po sa Pilipinas, at punta tayo sa ating satellite studio sa Macau. Hello po, mga kapatid.
Hello po, Kating. Good morning po. Kumusta po kayo dyan po?
Mabuti naman po kami dito, mga kapatid. At i-welcome na po natin ang INC Radio Macau sa inyong inihandang program.
INC Radio Macau Satellite Studio brings you smart, significant, memorable, adorable, refreshing, and timely episodes that will entertain and educate you with life skills and, most importantly, impart Christian values to guide you in your everyday life. So sit back, relax, and enjoy today's episode.
Pleasant day to all our avid viewers and listeners out there. We were so delighted that you will be joining us once again in our program. And we welcome you all here in INC Radio Macau Satellite Studio. And we are so glad to be here once again to bring another inspiring and significant episode tonight. I am Sister Nimpa Albano.
A wonderful Sunday to each and everyone, most especially to all our brethren church officers and our ministers and their families here in the District of Macau. Today is April 21, 2024, and time check now is already 9 p.m. in the evening. The weather here in Macau is rainy, but summer season is here, and the temperature ranges from 23 to 25 degrees Celsius. I am Sister Ermi Louie.
Yes, and you can watch us live streaming at our incradio.org or to our Facebook and Subsea Incorporated. In our website, we have here the https://incradio.iglesianicristo.net. And you can watch us also in our YouTube channel. And we have also our new mobile app, the INC Radio mobile app.
And of course, send your comments and greetings with your hashtag local and area as shown in the poster, and we will announce the winner of our hashtag challenge later at the end of our program.
Yes, and speaking of winners, Ate Mayor, we would like to congratulate all the hashtag winners challenge last week and all the in our episode that being mentioned later who will be the next winners again. And again, we would like to congratulate always the hashtag Bacau Area 1 for always being the winners po. And we are so excited po, Ate Mayor, for today's for this week's winners. And we will announce it later po during our program.
And of course, for our topic tonight, about the people who uncontrolled playing of video games, Sister Nipa. Let's find the answers in our episode tonight from the Iglesia Ni Cristo and the Bible entitled Dangers Caused by Uncontrolled Playing of Video Games. Let's all watch and listen attentively.
The use of social media nowadays is prevalent and helps people develop their interests and find other people who share the same interest. However, sometimes it poses dangers when improperly used. Find out this Sunday, April 21 at 9 p.m. China Standard Time and Philippine Time, as INC Radio Macau Satellite Studio presents the dangers caused by uncontrolled playing of video games. See you there!
Radio Macau Satellite Studio, and that was very meaningful discussion for later, Sister Mayor.
Yes.
And we hope that makasama po namin kayo sa mga pagsubaybay po sa ating programa ngayong gabi. And we also like to invite to continue all the avid viewers po to watch our program for tonight. And as we are waiting po for the Kuya Tech po from the main studio for playing po about our topic po for tonight.
Today's topic, gaming addictions. Can addictions, such as gaming addictions, really hinder a person from attaining eternal life in the kingdom of heaven? Can addictions cause destruction of a person's life? Does the Bible provide guidance on how to ensure gaming or any other entertainment in life would not end up leading a person away from service to God? Take a look at this video before we begin our discussion.
It's happening in virtually every developed country in the world. Young people, usually boys, unable to walk away from online video games. It could be Fortnite, Counter-Strike, Minecraft, the list is long, as kids sacrifice family, friends, school, even sleep.
There are families today being shaken up by what started out as just playing video games, but turned into a serious addiction. In a digital modern age, let's explore today what the Bible actually reveals about the perils of addictions and discover what we can do to safeguard ourselves as well as our families. While gaming, of course, can be enjoyable, but some may ask even, is playing video games a sin? Or am I really addicted to gaming? Today we'll talk about how the Bible urges us to maintain balance and to prioritize our relationships with God and loved ones. But how do we do that? Hello, I'm Bob Pauline, and we'll find out today the answers to these questions and much more right here on the Iglesia Ni Cristo International Edition. And joining in today's discussion is Brother Dexter Manglikmot in Washington, D.C., Brother Felmar Sereno in British Columbia, Canada, as well as Brother Marvin Adriano in Paris, France. Brothers, thank you so much for helping us and joining us in this very important discussion.
How's it going, brothers?
Brothers, today, as I've mentioned, we're talking about the dangers of gaming addiction. So I guess the question then right here from the outset is, well, what is addiction, brothers, and why should Christians make sure that they're not controlled by any of it?
Hello, Brother Bob. And before we define what addiction is, let me just cite some statistics about gaming here in the United States. According to Entertainment Software Association, more than 214 million Americans play video games. And Statista says nearly 10% of American gaming population plays video games for 20 or more hours per week. Well, some might say, well, what's the big deal? Isn't gaming harmless? Well, in another report released by Iowa State University in 2008, a National Harris poll of almost 1,200 American youths found nearly 1 in 10 gamers were found to be pathological players. In short, they were addicted to gaming. And because of that, there were family, social, school, or psychological damage because of their video game playing habits. So if we were to quote from mental health experts, well, addiction is the repeated involvement with a substance or activity despite the substantial harm it now causes, because that involvement was and may continue to be pleasurable and or valuable.
You know, that what you're reading there and quoting from there, but it seems very strange, you know, because let's pose this question together. Why would anyone repeatedly involve themselves in something if in fact they're being harmed by it, right? Let's go to you, Brother Marvin, in Paris.
Brother Bob, people continue to engage or get involved in things that, even though these things are harmful to them, because that involvement may continue to be pleasurable and or valuable, just like what Brother Dexter said. Just here in France, Brother Bob, there are around 31 million regular gamers, according to an article, and among them are children aged 10 to 17. And of those children aged 10 to 17, 96% say that they play video games regularly.
You know, Brother Marvin, brothers, you know, when we hear of addiction, what often comes to mind when you hear of addiction, normally you would only think of it as like, okay, the addiction to like alcohol or addiction to gambling or pornography, illegal drug addiction. Those kind of addictions are pretty well known. But what else has been identified then, brothers, is as an addiction because it has endangered people's lives aside from those very obvious dangerous addictions.
Brothers, in response to that, here's a quote from an article published in 2018. It reads, "In June, the World Health Organization, WHO, included gaming addiction on a list of diagnostic conditions. The WHO defines gaming disorder as a condition involving addictive behaviors where someone loses control over their gaming to the extent that it takes over other parts of their life with negative consequences." You know, on that, if I could share a quick story. A couple weeks back, we were at basketball practice for a Unity Games. And I got to talking with his dad. And I asked him, you know, where's your son? Why didn't he come out today to play? And he made this face and gesture, you know, signaling it was because of gaming. And I could feel, you know, just from that exchange, I could feel the worry. And it's not just with that particular dad. I've spoken with not a few parents from here, British Columbia, who have expressed their concerns over their child's screen time and gaming.
I think it's not only a worry for many parents there in British Columbia, Brother Felmar. I'm sure in most, in many places where gaming is popular, that it may very well be getting a bit out of control in the lives of more than just a few. For example, Brother Dexter, because maybe someone would say, it's not that big of a problem. It's not really an addiction like some of those other addictions you mentioned, alcohol and drugs and such like that. But what are really then some of the really harmful or negative consequences if one would become addicted to their gaming?
Very good questions, Brother Bob. And here in an online article, it says there, in several documented cases, interactive gaming has led to divorce, job loss, and health problems among those who suffer from an addiction. As the addiction develops, children may experience symptoms of withdrawal, which include anxiety, depression, irritability, trembling hands, restlessness, and obsessive thinking or fantasizing about the internet. Relationships in the real world may be neglected as those in the virtual world increase in importance. Academic performance is likely to suffer.
You know, brothers, considering that what you're just quoting there, Brother Dexter, with those kind of things in mind, those kind of genuine concerns, what controls the people that develop these kind of conditions, these kind of addictions?
Another great question, Brother Bob, and instead of going to online sources, we're going to the best source, the Holy Scriptures or the Bible. And the Bible has this to say here in 2 Peter, the chapter is 2 and the verse is 19. This is what the Bible teaches unto us. They promise them freedom while they themselves are slaves of destructive habits. For we are slaves of anything that has conquered us. So when people can no longer control their repeated involvement in an activity, despite negative consequences, then they become like what the Bible describes here as slaves of such destructive habits. A bad habit or a repeated involvement in an activity that cannot be controlled and is destructive, well, that could eventually lead to a person committing sin.
Obviously, right? Okay, brothers, what are some real-life examples of this? Okay, we've received some quotes now from some very reputable agencies, and most especially from the Holy Scriptures. But how about some real-life examples? And anything that you can cite for the sake of our viewers?
Well, Brother Bob, for example, and this is really happening, the head of a family loses his job because of gaming addiction, right? And consequently fails to provide for his family. And as he has become irresponsible, well, the Bible actually brands such as worse than an unbeliever. It's based on 1 Timothy chapter 5, verse 8.
That's correct, Brother Felmar. And also in addition to that, if a marriage has been ruined because one spends too much time role-playing as an avatar with his guild in an online world, instead of spending more quality time with his wife, well, then he violates the biblical teaching of love and concern that a married couple should have for one another.
And another problem, brothers, brought about by addiction to video gaming is, say, for example, 18, spends all his or her time in internet gaming cafes instead of planning and preparing for his or her future. This clearly constitutes a clear violation of God's teaching that the youth should value their education and their future as written in Proverbs 4:13, 26 to 27.
But wait just a moment, brothers. You know, maybe someone would say, or like want to respond and say, It's my life, right? Just leave me alone. Do what I want. If I want to game, then I will game. It's my own freedom to do what I want. So, is there anything, brothers, that someone who's thinking like that, is there something that they should that they should know, that they should understand, that could maybe help them? For example, is there any evil consequence or bad consequence of allowing one's own life to be subjugated to addictions, to gaming, or any addiction for that matter? Let's have a short glimpse for a sec in the repercussions of gaming addiction in this short newsreel. Take a look.
That was a beautiful shot.
With few friends around during COVID, 15-year-old James Reichardt in Colorado turned to his Xbox for online gaming.
But I got a weekly report and it said he'd been on for like 40 hours.
Now his parents have had to set limits.
He has to have his homework done and his chores, as well as maintain a 3.0 or higher grade point average. So then we will basically unlock the Xbox so he can play, because we're able to pause the Wi-Fi to it.
Brothers, after seeing that particular clip, it certainly leads us to pose this simple question. How should we live our lives so that that won't happen? We won't end up being controlled by destructive habits and addictions.
Once again, we turn to the Holy Scriptures for guidance. Apostle Paul has this to say, as recorded here in 1 Corinthians 9, 25 as well as 26. Now every athlete who goes into training and competes in the games is disciplined and exercises self-control in all things. They do it to win a crown that withers, but we do it to receive an imperishable crown that cannot wither. Therefore, I do not run without a definite goal. I do not flail around like one beating the air, just shadow boxing. Well, it is common knowledge that athletes are so very competitive that they set short as well as long-term goals. They also stick to schedule so that they could stay on track in their training and that they never get distracted.
And another testament to the discipline that we can find in athletes is that they're even ready to deny themselves or sacrifice certain pleasures. They will not engage or get involved in things that they know could harm in attaining their greater goals. For example, when it comes to their diet, we know that they make sure to avoid foods that they know could affect their weight negatively. Or when it comes to their training, they deny themselves social pleasures like going out with friends to focus on their greater goal. So as to say, athletes, they truly practice rigid self-control and discipline.
Agreed, Brother Marvin. So, dear friends, based on what the Bible teaches, let's practice self-control and discipline by monitoring the time we spend on the computer, gaming, or other devices, and by setting time limits for ourselves or our children if we have kids already.
Thank you very much, brothers. Dear friends, coming up next, what is God's command to parents and to children as well so that they may lead disciplined lives and not fall into any such kind of addictions that we've been discussing? That's where we'll pick up and respond as the Iglesia Ni Cristo International Edition continues. Stay with us. Welcome back to the Iglesia Ni Cristo International Edition. Before the break, we studied what is gaming addiction and the repercussions it poses on families in the modern world we live in. So, what is a vital responsibility of the parents so that they can instill proper values and discipline that God wants His people to observe? Let's go back to you in Paris, France, Brother Marvin.
Brother Bob, we will once again go to the Bible for guidance. What does the Bible say when it comes to the divine responsibility of parents to their children? Let us read here in Proverbs 31, 26 to 27. When she speaks, her words are wise and kindness is the rule for everything she says. She watches carefully all that goes on throughout her household and is never lazy. So according to the Bible, parents are expected not only to teach wise words, not only to teach Christian instruction, but also to supervise, to be on top of things when it comes to the activities of their family. So as to say, parents must know what is going on in the lives of their children.
That's absolutely correct, Brother Marvin, and it's very important for parents to do that. On the other hand, the children also have a responsibility. Children should not be upset when their parents check on their activities. Parents are supposed to watch carefully all that goes on in their own household, and as well as teach their children. This is what children should also understand. This is a commandment of our Lord God so that the children can be well cared for.
You know, brothers, in the past decade or so, you know, social media as well as, you know, the smartphone, of course, has become just a normal part of everyone's life. So how should we effectively cope so that all of the devices, the smartphones and the various tablets and such, and the use of social media that's contained on such devices always, as well as the gaming that we've been discussing together in our discussions today, how we make sure that those things won't end up controlling our life?
Brother Bob, this is what the Bible says when it comes to the use of the things of the world. Let's read in 1 Corinthians 7:31. Those who use the things of the world should not become all wrapped up in them. The world, as it now exists, is passing away. So the truth is, there's nothing wrong with using the internet per se. In fact, the internet, computers, mobile devices, such as our smartphones, are useful even in the conduct of our services unto our Lord God. It is useful in one's livelihood or education, and even in providing entertainment as well.
Right, Brother Marvin, it's thanks to breakthroughs in technology that we're able to have this discussion today, right? Although we're in different parts of the world. But dear friends, our use of computers and the internet, what we need to understand is that it can become harmful if and when we get so enwrapped in it that we would no longer be able to control our usage. And such even becomes evil when the fulfilling of one's duties and responsibilities to their family, and above all to God, suffers because of such addictions.
Exactly. So then, brothers, what should all of us do? Here's the thing. What should we do so that no one would be enslaved by such destructive habits or addictions? None of our viewers would want that. So what other or additional counsel does the Bible provide, Brother Dexter?
The Bible does say something that has to do with overcoming addiction and bad habits. Here in 1 Corinthians 15:33 as well as 58, Apostle Paul teaches this. Do not be misled. Bad company corrupts good character. So then, my dear friends, stand firm and steady. Keep busy always in your work for the Lord, since you know that nothing you do in the Lord's service is ever useless. Apostle Paul teaches us, don't be misled. Bad company corrupts good character. What does that have to do with addiction? Well, dear friends, addiction is acquired. That's why when people spend too much time with so-called friends who are also addicted to something, well, their tendency is also for them to be influenced to have that kind of addiction or have that destructive habit. And it could pull them into that kind of problem as well, especially when they spend their time in idleness.
And you know, the viewers, we also do understand that while we live in this world, we eventually, It'll be times that we are wearied, moments of weakness, where we may be vulnerable to life's temptations, right? So, brothers, what does our Lord Jesus Christ teach for the sake of all maybe viewing this program so that no one would be overcome by any temptations that one would face in this life? What's the counsel of the Lord Jesus?
Brother Bob, we can read about that here in the book of Matthew, chapter 26. The verse is 41. Watch and pray, lest you enter into temptation. The spirit indeed is willing, but the flesh is weak. According to our Lord Jesus Christ, we should watch and pray. So we better keep our guard up so that we won't be bested by temptations. Now, what are ways that we can do this, dear friends? Well, for starters, stay away, right? Stay away from the things that may trigger those harmful addictions. Like if it's a particular game that's destroying our productivity, well, maybe it's time to delete that game. Let's also be wise in choosing who we spend our time with. We can ask ourselves, will those people, those friends, help me to develop healthy habits or destructive addictions? Let's also be wise in deciding where we spend our time, whether in physical places and online. And let's not forget what the Lord Jesus taught. We should couple such steps with prayer. Now, friends, if you'd like to learn more about the power of prayer, the right way to pray, or other topics and other teachings that we uphold in the Iglesia Ni Cristo, the Church of Christ, the invitation is always open. Please, we welcome you to join us in our worship services and our Bible studies. You can log on to incmedia.org for more information.
Well, dear friends, we'd like to thank Brother Dexter Manglikmot there in Washington, D.C., as well as Brother Felmar Soreno in British Columbia, Canada, and Brother Marvin Adriano in Paris, France. Brothers, thank you for giving to us Bible-based answers. Well, that does it for us here today on the Iglesia Ni Cristo International Edition. We hope you'll join us again next time. I'm Bob Pauline. Thanks for watching. And as always, we invite you to join us for a short closing prayer.
Our Father, who is in heaven,
yes, Lord.
With humble hearts, we call to you in prayer. May you have mercy to listen to us, O God.
Yes, Lord.
First of all,
yes,
we express Lord. Our thanks for this program, the advice, especially your words written in the Bible that we have received. We know, O God, all of this is meant to better our lives. And most of all, O Father, to lead us on the right path that leads to salvation. And so we ask, help us to understand and embrace everything we have heard today. And may we put it into practice, dear Father, that we can save ourselves from destructive addictions. And we can commit ourselves to follow your way, the way you have always intended us to live. Not only so that we will have a peaceful and happy life, but most of all, we will reach the holy city, that place where there is true joy and lasting happiness. And so we call out to you as well, Lord Jesus. Please mediate our prayers to the Father. And dear Lord, have mercy on anyone who may be struggling with any kind of addiction. May we find comfort in your teachings. May we put them into practice, and may you help all of us, dear Lord, to align ourselves with the will of our God.
Amen.
Dear Father, Amen. May you continue to bless the Church of Christ under the leadership of our administration. Thank you for their concern for us, even using modern means of communication to preach the gospel of salvation. We believe, Father, you have heard our prayer. Please forgive our sins. These we ask in the name of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Defies all odds, glorious we rise, rise,
shine, shine, shine. Beloved something, we take heat and bow to lead in last journey. How we follow the lead of the Sugo and God. Stand by your side, the nation unifies. We have read the text of the scriptures. Brother Stein.
Never leave.
Yes, welcome back to INC Radio Macau Satellite Studio and Time Check Point. It's already 9:40 in the evening. And that was a very meaningful discussion based on our God's teaching written in the Bible. We hope that we inspired all the one that have seen this program from the Holy Gospel, and to all the ministers and Brother Bob Pillian, who teaches us lately, Sister Mier. Yes. And please continue to listen and more to our doctrines held inside the Church of Christ. Ayan, at na marami po tayong natutunan about how to use by addicting of video games, kung paano yung leisure time po natin, kung paano mo siya dapat gamitin, na dapat hindi po tayo nagiging addict. Opo. And hindi po tayo nagiging slaves po while using all those video games. Ate Mir?
Yes, and of course, the parents po is the one who is responsible for yes. the of their children to
and needs to supervise yes. their children. Yes. Po. Always need to supervise the activity na ginagawa ng yes. sambahayan, lalong-lalo na po yung mga bata po. And how to use the social media po at the end here. And make sure of it na nakokontrol yung children po o yung bata na ano gumamit ng social media, ganun po.
Yes, and napakinggan po natin yung sinabi ng nasa Biblia na hindi po masama ang mga internet po. Yung phone, yung mga hindi po masama. Ang masama lang yung paano natin gamitin.
Gamitin po natin yun ng tama.
Yes.
Yes, lalong-lalo na po sa mga kabataan po ngayon, Sister Mier. Yung time nila dapat kung yung mga leisure time, especially po yung talagang nag-aano din sa mga gaming, dapat nililimitahan.
Dapat po, unahin muna nila yung future, yung sinasabi nilang future na halimbawa yung studies nila, dapat unahin before yung video games na nilalaro nila, di ba po?
Yes po.
And, yes
sister, sister. At dapat siguraduhin po natin din na hindi po tayo nakokontrol ng mga paggamit ng social media, ng paggamit ng gaming na
addiction.
Dapat hindi tayo nararap up sa mga ganung klaseng bagay po. And lalong-lalo na po tayo sa loob po ng Iglesia ni Cristo, natuturuan po tayo kung paano po gumamit po.
Yes po. Lalo-lalo mga
kabataan
dapat gabayan po
ng parents.
Yes, and also we also invite you all to continue attending in the different activities launched by the church administration and most especially in worship services here in our district. And before that, napakinggan natin kanina yung
rendition
po ng sa lokal lang sa Malo po, yung
yes po.
Hindi ka pababayaan ng Diyos po. Sister, yes. Pa, anong masasabi mo doon?
Dahil isa po ako sa kumanta yes. sa umawit kanina at napanood po natin. Medyo pwet pa ako doon natin.
Haba pa ng hair doon.
Yes po. At nakakatuwa po. Ito po ay isang kasiyahan po, kagalakan po sa ating sarili dahil kahit sa mga ganong aktibidad po, sa mga ganong kaganapan ng ating buhay, nakakasama po tayo. Lalong-lalo na po, ito po ay nagagamit po natin sa lalong paglilingkod po sa ating Panginoong Diyos.
Yes, and gaya po na yung inawit, hindi ka pababayaan ng Diyos, anumang mga pagsubok
yes.
po na darating sa atin.
Tamang po.
Kailangan lang natin manalangin lagi. Kailangan natin isumbong sa lahat kung ano man gusto natin sa buhay, yung mga nangyayari sa atin. Kailangan natin sabihin sa Kanya lahat-lahat para i-guide tayo.
Yes, at lumako naman po tayo yes. sa ating greetings po from our YouTube live chat po. Sa ating mga viewers and listeners po sa gabing ito, sa mga sumusubaybay po, sa lahat po ng mga sumusubaybay. Ayan.
Batiin po natin.
Yes. Bago nga po pala yan, nais po namin batiin po ang ating mahal na kapatid, ang Ka Jeff Miguel po, na nagdaraos po ng kanyang kaarawan po. And happy birthday po. At binabati ko din po ang tagapangasiwa po ng ating distrito, ang kapatid na Celestino Bagsapro po.
Yes, happy birthday po, Brother Jeff Bigil po ng
happy birthday po.
San Malo po. And of course, binabati po natin lahat ng mga nag-tune in po ngayong gabi. Lahat po ng mga kapatid sa distrito ng Macau, especially po sa lokal ng San Malo. San Malo.
Yan, binabati nga din po natin ang ating destinado po sa ating lokal. Ang yes. Kapatid na Sean Rick Erlang, maraming salamat po sa panonood at sa laging pag-subaybay po sa ating programa po. Ayan, any greetings po na sa yes. YouTube po, Ate Mayor?
Ang dami, hindi ko mabasa.
Nag-uunahan po sa hashtag.
Sa lahat po ng mga may tungkulin po sa lokal ng Macau Area 1, binabati po namin kayong lahat. At saka sa lokal ng Bara, at hindi din pa huli ang lokal ng Taipa, ang dami din. Hashtag Taipa, hashtag Macau, hashtag Bara. Hello po sa lahat po.
Makikita dito natin, no, Ate Mer, na talagang solid yung hashtag Macau Area 1. Ayan. At maraming salamat po sa mga po nagha-hashtag po at sa mag-hashtag po po.
Yes. And now, Sister Nimpa, let's find out the activities recently conducted in our district in our Macau News Update.
Macau News Update.
Waiting, and yes, while we are waiting po for the Kuya Tech po from the main studio sa mga aktibidad po na isinagawa
yes.
Upcoming po activities sa ating pong distrito. Ayan. Ayan, nakikita po natin dito ang mga kapatid po na sa lokal po ng Macau. Nagkaroon din po sila ng poster making po. Ayan, na makikita po natin ang ating mga kapatid po sa lokal po ng Macau
yes.
Sa kanilang pagkikipagpartisipasyon sa nasabing aktibidad. Ayan.
Nakita po natin ang kanilang mga galing po
yes,
sa paggawa po.
Po
ng poster making
yes,
po sa lokal ng Macau. Marami sa kanila ang nakilaho. Ng mga,
yes.
Hindi lang mga may tungkulin sa lokal ng Macau, pati rin mga kapatid
opo.
Na lumahok po.
Hindi mo akalain natin, Meno, na sa mga ganitong aktibidad, dito mo nakikita yung mga kapatid,
yes,
yung kanilang talento
yes.
Po, sa, lalong-lalo na po sa pagsali po sa mga ganitong aktibidad. Ayan.
Yes, and
ayan, at nagkaroon din po ng, sa lokal din po ng Macau, nagkaroon din po tayo ng Macau Kadiwa Seminar po na pinanganahan po ng ating mga kapatid na Kadiwa po. Sa pamamagitan din po ng kanilang mahal po na destinado, ang kapatid na Raul de Leon. Ayan, as nakikita po natin sa picture na maraming kapatid.
Kadiwa,
maraming
yes.
Kadiwa
ang nakakatuwa ang dami nila.
Opo. Excited tayo, no, Ate Mayor, pag mga ganitong activities,
yes.
Kung ano yung magiging topic po natin. Ayan. And sunod po is makikita po natin dito ang ating kapatid na Jocelyn Hill. About din po ito sa technical troubleshooting. Ayan. At ang ating mahal na destinadong Cassian de Curl Ang.
Ayan yes, po. Nagsagawa po ng nagsagawa po tayo ng pamamahayag po sa lokal ng Macau. Distrito po, sa distrito ng Macau, sorry.
Ayan.
Na pinangunahan po ng
mga may tungkulin.
Mga may tungkulin.
Yes po. Yes. Ito po ay distrito, no, Ate Mayor. So, lahat po ng ating lokal sa distrito po ng Macau ay nakipagkaisa po sa isinagawang evangelical mission po na pinangunahan ng ating mga kapatid na may tungkulin.
Yes, marami po ang nakinig at masaya po silang nakilaho.
Dumalo
po sa sinagawang aktibidad na yun.
Ayan. Ang dami nating aktibidad po sa ating distrito, atin.
Yes.
At
we, Sister Nimpa, we also like, we would like to thank our brethren who actively participated in all the church activities in our district supervision of all ministers of the gospel led by our district minister, Brother Celestino Baxabra. Yes, and for this winner in hashtag challenge, Sister Nimpa. Sino po ang nangunguna sa ating hashtag challenge?
Yes, Ate Mayor. Excited ka na ba sa top
1? Yes!
Always
alam
winner.
Alam ko na po, sino namumuna.
Yes po. And for that, balikan po natin kung sino po ang nanalo sa ating hashtag challenge po.
Yes! Ang number 1 po.
Ang top 3 po na 3. Hashtag challenge winners po for this week po is hashtag Macau Area 2 for being the third place. And second place is Macau Area 5 and then always po the Macau Area 1 po. Maraming salamat po mga kapatid. Patuloy lamang po kayong mag-hashtag po kasama po ng inyong local and areas po. Congratulations po sa inyo lahat po. Ayan, Ate Mayor. So karagdagan nga po sa ating sa plenary po kanina sa ating po sa video po na about sa addiction dangers caused by uncontrolled playing of video games. Ayan.
Yes.
Na talaga namang ito po ay napapanahon lalong-lalo na po ngayon, lalong-lalo na po yung mga kabataan ngayon kasi kung hindi naman po ako nagkakamali, ilang years na tayo. Iba na po yung, kumbaga, generation na yun. So, kailangan po talaga dito yung paggabay ng isang magulang. Kailangan yung pagbabantay. Upang nang sa ganun, habang bata pa, di ba? Gaya nga po ng ating nalalaman, habang bata pa yung ating anak, kailangan na po natin silang turuan. Upang nang sa ganun, paglaki nila ay talagang dalhin po nila yun hanggang saan po sila pumunta.
Yes. Lalong-lalo ngayon, di ba, ang dami ng mga influencer po.
Yes, po.
Kailangan gabayan natin sila kung sino-sino yung mga pina-follow nila sa social media po.
Saka kung ano yung mga website
yes.
na kanilang nabivisit kasi kailangan talaga dun yung supervision ng isang parents.
Sabi nga nila, think before you click.
Yes po. Lalong-lalo na po, social media to, it is all over the globe po. So, we make sure po that it will not control us in our daily lives. And gaya nga po, the parents should be supervise the activity, the lives of their children. Lalong-lalo na po sa pamilya at saka may asawa na po, di ba po? Kung yung tatay ay talagang nagtatrabaho din, upang nang sa ganun, magkaroon ng kapayapaan sa kanilang tahanan, hindi po nagiging problema yung kanilang pong mga anak po.
At saka gaya ng napakinggan natin kanina, halimbawa yung mga kabataan ngayon, kung napapagalitan man kayo ng mga magulang nyo, dahil hindi yun galit na
galit talaga.
Na,
yun
ano,
po ay
magtutuwid.
Yes,
yung po. Ginagawa nyo para maituwid kayo.
Opo, tama po. Yes, napaka talagang napapanahon
yes.
Ate Mayor yung ating pong topic discussions for tonight. At nagpapasalamat po tayong lahat sa lahat po ng mga dumalo, sa mga sumubaybay po sa gabing ito po. Yes po Ate Mayor, before we say goodbye po, we would like to thank our brother Arnel Solano, our station manager, and brother Sam Dalan, our overseeing minister po, Sister Ivy Joy Butea, our executive producer, and Tukoya Technical from the main studio.
And we would also like to thank brother Celestino Baxafra, our district supervising minister, brother Shandrick Earl Ang, our CFO overseer, and to all the ministers here in our district and to their families. And Sister Karen Faith Simpleo, the INC Radio Macau satellite studio producer, and to Kuya Tech Crow here in our studio.
Brother Brian
Danilan.
And with Sister Ellen.
Ate Ellen.
Yes. And we would also like to thank our Brother Aranyo Manalo, President and CEO of CEPC, and our CFO Coordinator, and to our beloved Executive Minister, Brother Eduardo V. Manalo, and most importantly, to our Almighty God.
And of course, Sister Nimpa, watch the replays po of the episode in our various social watching INC Radio Macau Satellite Studio. I am Sister Ermi Lul.
Yes, and I am Sister Nimpa Albano. See you again next week, same day, same time. And coming up next, INC Radio Spain Satellite Studio. Thank you po.
Want more? See you again next week for another smart episode only here in INC Radio Macau Satellite Studio. INC Radio Reminders.
Mula sa mga simpleng salita,
anak, maraming salamat sa padala mo. Makakabili na ka.